What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of my vlog Catch 22 with Adeola. I'm so sorry I'm looking this way this morning, but I just had to come up here and fulfill my part of my responsibility of making sure that I post something here and keeping you up to date with things going on in my mind and all. So today I don't really have anything to say, seriously, but I woke up this morning and my mentor was like, "What's up? Where's our vlog? You didn't post last week, so where's our vlog for today?" And one of my friends already called yesterday to ask me, "What's happening? Where's our vlog?" And I'm like, he's like, "These people won't like take it from me if I don't post this week." And I know there are so many people out there that are also watching, seeing, expecting me to post something. And I'm very, very sorry that I've not been keeping to the parts, my own part. So I'm here today, even though I don't really have anything to say. I'm calling this just rant, like. Yeah, guys, I attended my last CDS yesterday. Day before yesterday, we had the news that we would be passing out next week, Thursday, 27th of June. Going for my final CDS. Like, after all this while, the NYC have used to tell us when we are going to go back home. We got the news that we'll be having our POP next week, Thursday. So, even though I'm supposed to have had my break, like how many weeks ago now, we are going for a final day yesterday. I'm thankful. I'm really thankful. I don't know if I want to leave again. I'm having these mixed feelings. But still, my POP is next week, Thursday. Then we'll come and say hi.
Hello.
Say to my friend.
Hello.
2019. I actually entered camp 23rd of June 2018. So which means I'm even spending more than a year here, and it's been a great journey going to camp, staying here and all. There were days when I wanted to go to families and friends and there was none, and I just had to stay on my own. Christmas, New Year, my birthday was like the worst test of it all, because I was literally on my bed throughout that day. I didn't do anything. I was down, got to a point I wanted to start crying. I couldn't put my calls because I just feel like, why am I here where I don't have people? And it's just me. And I'm the indoor type of person. Like, I really don't go out if it's not like very, very, very necessary. Like, it's very mandatory for me to go out and do something. If not, I just stay indoors. So I've not really had the opportunity to go out, to meet these and understand with that. I felt staying on my own and at least maybe writing songs and reading, doing something, you understand? So I've sometimes boredom and all, but church has really helped. Going to church, we at the house, music has always been there for me. So I'm saying a very big thank you. I say, if music is a human being, I will do everything in my power to make sure that it doesn't slip away from my fingers. But thank God, it's a gift, and so it's always here with us. So I'm thankful, and for just to put that, music has actually always been their way out too. Just put your hands up and you understand. Just bear me witness. So I'm passing out next week, and I'm very, very, very happy. I attended my last CDS yesterday and took pictures with a lot of people, funny parties. I've been receiving gifts, and I'm so grateful to God. I'm like, because I feel it's like I really didn't meet people, I really didn't do this, I really didn't do that, but I really thank God that even the short time really, really matters. I'm very grateful to God, and I'm just feeling like I'm going to cry, maybe leaving my peeps in church, my roommates, my baby, like I don't know how it's going to be whenever we are going to like go apart. I stay in Ibadan actually, and she stays in Abeokuta, and you know, I have a few friends here. And so one of my people yesterday was crying at the CDS, and she was like, "I'm going to miss you and all," and I'm like, God, like I will not even get to see some people for the rest of my life. But really, this 1 year has been worth it. God has opened my eyes to so many things I never knew existed in my life before. Like me being judgy, always wanting to have my own say, not, you understand, not being close to him and all. And it's been awesome experiencing the ash weather here in Sokoto. But there's always excess. If there's rain, it's in excess. Sun, excess. Breeze, excess. Amatan. But you know, I've experienced all and I'm standing, so I feel like now I can like stay in a place and for at least a particular number of time without my families, and like just stay alone, enjoy my me time. Like the past 10, was it 10 days? Last weekend, I think the week before, break off line. And I had a time with me and God, and I prayed, studied, and all, because I've been thinking about how much time social media actually takes for me and how much energy. Sometimes I just feel like I'm stressed and all, and because I'm always expecting a message from this person, trying to keep up with that person, trying to update my status, my notifications, get this, get that, and all. I just have to put everything beside me and just focus on me. So I would say at this time, I think I can enjoy my me time without being dependent on someone else, or maybe getting my joy and being satisfied from someone else.
That's a very, very good thing, because I've never lived like stayed away from my family for a long time. I wouldn't say all my life. I schooled in Ife, which is just like an hour drive from Ibadan. So whenever I feel down, fix up this video and post today. I have to fix up this video and post today. So I want to say it's been a great journey, and very soon I'll be going back home. And I know there are so many people that like me that are passing out, and you started thinking, what next, what do I do, where do I go, and all. Immediately they told us, like, I've always been like, I want to leave, I'm tired, until they told us that we're going. And I've started having mixed feelings, like, really, I'm going to like leave these people, I'm not going to see these people, I'm not going to stay in this place. Like, I'll be here in a few hours, and in the next day or 2 days after, I'll be in another location, and I might not be able to come here for life anymore. So I've been like having the mixed feelings, and I've been down, and the fear and all, but I have just learned to put everything aside and just talk to God about them, because whenever he says he's going to do something, he is not a man that he will lie. So I trust that he's going to bring everything to pass. So I would say, as much as you are planning, have faith. Put the fear beside. The Bible says the love casted out fear. So when we trust someone enough, you trust them that they can do whatever they say they will do. So, and I think the same should apply to God. Whenever he says he's going to do something, he's definitely going to do it. So I would say that let us calm down, and as much as we are going down there, let us just go with the peace, and you know, just try and work things out. Don't work yourself up about what else. I've waited this 1 year, I'm not saved, I'm not. You can't turn back the hands of time. Be gentle with yourself. Yes, and just let us enjoy whatever time we have left, and pack our stuff and go back home, and go and get ready, like face life squarely and get things to happen. So I think that's all I'll be saying for today. I'm trying to make this video to be as short as possible, because I don't really have much on my mind to say. But I want to thank everybody that has been on this journey with me since the beginning of my vlog, when I got here to Sokoto. So I'm very grateful to everybody that's been part of this journey, all Catherine's two family. I'm very, very grateful to you. I'm not saying this is the end of my vlog. I'm going to be continuing. I'm even going to bring into you powerfully my POP story. I'm going to capturing every moment, and I'm going to be posting it here for everyone, so you can enjoy and thank God with me. So I want to thank everybody that's been on this journey with me. Thank you very, very, very much. Let's meet in great places. Let's do big things for ourselves, for families, and for that big being out there, God. So till mix next week, always remember that life is your catch 22. You can't fight it nor resist it. The only way to fight life is to accept it. So speak your truth today, as it can help some people from giving up from depression. So I love you all. Peace out.